I never actually intended to get an education. I dreamed about flying airplanes, and so I wanted to go to the military and become a fighter pilot. But my senior years, I started to look into transitioning into what my next steps would be. I decided not to opt to go into the Air Force. I decided to pursue a career in law enforcement, federal law enforcement in particular. While I was in college, I worked at the Sheriff's Department, and a 14-year-old kid had been convicted of a murder charge and sentenced to life. And I remember bringing him back from court, and he looked up at me in the elevator, and he asked me, "What time is it?" And his response was, "Did I miss basketball?" And a 14-year-old who's just convicted of a life sentence and will spend the rest of his life in prison, only concerned about basketball, that was very impressionable to me. And so I asked myself, how can I stem the tide of juveniles or adults being incarcerated for extended amounts of time, as opposed to responding to it after the fact? So that's how I transitioned into education. My experiences are similar to some of the students' experiences, and I use my story as a mechanism to offer them hope. 75216, the zip code I grew up in, actually has the highest incarceration rate in the state of Texas currently. And so if somebody can come from an environment where gangs and drugs was what you saw every single day, then the experiences they have in DeSoto ISD can't be any worse than that. And so how do you focus on your hopes and dreams? I try to remind them that's what's gonna move you to success in life. And allow the people around you, whether it's your family, whether it's the educators, to assist you in reaching those goals. I don't care about the title. My job is to serve the students. It's to serve the parents. It's to serve the community. I always try to say that it's about the kids. It's never about me. It's never about the grown-ups in the building. It's about the students that we serve. And if they can have opportunities in life, just like I was afforded opportunities or the adults are afforded opportunities, then it's our responsibility to make sure that that happens. I can't make a student do anything that they don't want to do or choose to do. But what I can do is make sure that I provide myself and the staff provides of themselves to give the children the best shot at being successful and reaching their goals and dreams. I'm Homer Webb III, the principal of the DeSoto Alternative Education Programs.